Hello and welcome to New Orleans Square. On July 24th, 1966, Victor Shiro, then mayor of New Orleans, dedicated this new land. It was the first land added to Disneyland since the park's opening in 1955. It cost $18 million to build this new 3-acre land. While you are visiting the square, you can stroll down three winding streets. Along the backside, along the railroad, is Front Street. The street with the most shops and restaurants is Royal Street. And between these two is Orleans, which has entrances to Crystal d'Orleans and Jules d'Orleans. While you are enjoying your walk, be sure to look up and admire the details. In the distance, you might see the mass of pirate ships at dock. Notice the iron wrought balconies with Walt's and Roy's initials. There are many quaint coves and richly decorated balconies. You might even hear a tale or two from the windows.
Come on, sing, please. Shh. Oh, stop it. I thought we got rid of that song a long time ago. I just can't stand it.
Listen to the bird.
As you stroll along the streets, you will find many restaurants, shops, and street vendors. And you never know when you might bump into a Dixieland jazz band. New Orleans is home to several different restaurants where you can get something to eat and drink. The jewel of New Orleans Square is the dining under the perpetual moonlit sky of the Blue Bayou Restaurant. This restaurant overlooks the initial stages of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride. While dining, you can hear the occasional strumming of a banjo and see the dancing lights of fireflies in the distance. Located near the entrance of the Disney Gallery and down the street from the Blue Bayou is the Royal Street Veranda. Here you can get clam chowder or gumbo served in a bread bowl. Located across Royal Street is the Café Orléans. Here you will find sandwiches and salads and other wonderful treats. And across New Orleans is the French Market. This buffeteria restaurant is where you can choose many fine dishes drawing their heritage from the South. As you take your dinner out on the patio, you might be even entertained by a jazz band. On a hot day, be sure to swing by the Mint Julep Bar for a refreshing minty drink. New Orleans Square is home to the most hidden restaurant in the park, Club 33. Club 33 is a members-only restaurant situated above the central core shops in New Orleans Square on Royal Street. If you ever have the opportunity, please be sure to visit this wonderful restaurant. Located next to Royal Street Veranda, you will find Le Bâton Rouge. Here you can find Haunted Mansion-related items, including Holiday Haunted Mansion and Nightmare Before Christmas items. Pieces of Eight is a novelty toy store immediately at the exit of the Pirates of the Caribbean. You'll be able to pick up pirate souvenirs, pennants, toy pistols and rifles, rubber knives, and of course, Pieces of Eight. It's Christmas year-round at this little shop, the Boutique de Noël, just beyond the Blue Bayou and Club 33. Here you will find all manner of Disney Christmas ornaments and other holiday decorations. Also in celebration of Christmas is l'Ornement Magique, which features the work of Christopher Radko. Across the way is Masquerade's The Only On Shop. This store normally features harlequin masks, sequins, and other masks reminiscent of New Orleans. Currently, the store is hosting the All-American Pin event. The Crystal d'Orléans features glassware and crystal pieces. You can have them monogrammed or engraved as a lasting souvenir. From great costume jewelry to very exquisite pieces of jewelry can be found here in the Jewel of Orléans. New Orleans Square is home to four major attractions. The first is the Disney Gallery, located at the front of New Orleans Square over the Pirates of the Caribbean. The Disney Gallery was originally built to be a private apartment for Walt and Roy Disney, but it never fulfilled that purpose. In 1987, the gallery became home to a showcase of Disney art, Imagineering, and special exhibits. Currently, there is a tribute to the Haunted Mansion, the ride, and the movie. In the evenings, you can purchase one of 16 seats to watch Fantasmic from a completely unobstructed viewpoint. The Disneyland Railroad has a station here at New Orleans Square, which was originally known as the Frontierland Railroad Station.
Now arriving from a trip around Walt Disney's Magic Kingdom, passengers will stand by to board.
Behind the tracks, an observant guest can hear the clicking of Morse code. Yes, this is an actual message. It is the opening day address by Walt Disney. The Haunted Mansion was built on the shores of River America in 1963, and for 6 years, only the mansion was there. This ride did not open until August 9th of 1969. Out of these dormant years, many urban legends were born. The Haunted Mansion is currently home to 999 happy haunts from all over the world, but there's always room for another.
Our tour begins here in this gallery, where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state. Is this haunted room actually stretching, or is it your imagination? We find it delightfully unlivable here in this ghostly retreat. Every room has wall-to-wall creeps and hot and cold running chills.
Creepies and crawlies, toads in a pond. Let there be music from regions beyond.
I'll see you all a little later.
A silly spook, place it by your side.
Shrouded in a dark disguise,
they pretend to terrorize.
Grim windows come out to socialize.
Hurry back. Be sure to bring your death certificate if you decide to join us.
Walt introduced the concept of a pirate adventure to his wed staff in the late 1950s. At one time, the ride was going to be a walk-through attraction. Technology for animatronics grew in the early 60s and helped to create the pirates that we now know and love. It was March 18, 1967 that we got to sail with the rowdiest crew that ever plundered the Spanish Main. This attraction is home to over 119 lifelike animatronics. Pirates is truly one of the Disney classics. One special point of interest about the Pirates of the Caribbean is that this was the final ride that Walt personally worked on before passing away.
Mark well me words, mateys. Dead men tell no tales.
Fill up your white flag!
You will never surrender!
Very well, then. Give him a broadside! Hold them, lads! Hold them!
Speak up, you bilge rat!
Where be the treasure?
Have a nice bone, eh? It's a good leg.